Hello and welcome to Dell Networking Solutions Engineering. In this video, we'll be looking at deploying VMware Virtual SAN on PowerEdge FX2 chassis. This will be part 1 of this video. In this example, the FX2 chassis contains 4 FC430 servers, 2 FD332 storage blocks, and 2 FN410s. Let's take a look at the topology that is used in this example. This is a simple scenario using one top of rack switch. Most data center solutions would have 2 top of rack switches. There are 4 FC430 servers and 2 FN410s IO modules in the chassis. Port channels 15 and 14 run from top of rack switch S4048 to FN410s modules in slot A1 and A2. The two FN410s modules that we are using here are in standalone mode. It requires zero touch, hence we won't be looking at any configuration on the FN410s in this video. Before configuring VSAN, let's take a look at the configuration of port channel 15 on S4048. There's a description added to the link. We give it as port mode hybrid and we make it switch port. Note that the interfaces TE1/15 as well as interface TE1/16 are part of this port channel. We use the protocol LACP to add these two interfaces to port channel 15. Moving on to the next port channel, which is port channel 14, we can see that the interfaces 13 and 14 are part of this port channel. The configuration is similar to the configuration of port channel 15. Protocol LACP is used here. For VSAN, we create VLAN 30. We assign an IP address to the VLAN. We tag the port channels 14 as well as 15 with VLAN 30. One important part of the configuration is to make sure that we use IGMP snooping command here, which is IP IGMP snooping querier. In addition, make sure that IGMP snooping is enabled. Use IP IGMP snooping enable command in the global configuration mode to activate IGMP snooping. VSAN uses multicast to deliver metadata traffic among cluster nodes. IGMP snooping querier is used to limit the physical switch ports participating in the multicast group to only VSAN VM kernel interfaces. Let's take a look at the environment that has been set up using VMware vSphere web client before we enable VSAN. There is a cluster created with 4 hosts. Let's take a look at one of the hosts. Click on Manage, followed by Networking. There is a standard switch that has been created, vSwitch 0. The VM kernel VSAN that we are using in this example is associated with vSwitch 0. The two physical adapters, VMNIC 0 and VMNIC 1, are associated with vSwitch 0 through which they can interact with the VM kernel port VSAN. Let's take a look at vSwitch 0 settings. The settings in Properties, Security and Traffic Shaping are left to the default settings. Click on Teaming and Failover. Load Balancing, Network Failure Detection, Notify Switches and Fallback Options are left at default. We have VMNIC 0 as an active adapter and VMNIC 1 as a standby adapter. Let's take a look at the VM kernel adapter that we're using in this case. This kernel adapter has been named VSAN. It has been tagged to a VLAN ID of 30. It has been assigned an IP address. As you scroll down the properties, we can look at the information that's displayed for active as well as standby adapters. Let's take a look at the storage section. Click on the storage tab. In this section that says storage adapters, we are able to see the 8 disks that will be used in this example. Note that all the drive types are flash. For all the 4 hosts used in this example, 8 disks are presented from the 2 FD332 storage blocks. In this video, we looked at the configuration on S4048 switch that was used as a top-of-rack switch, as well as the environment used in this example through VMware vSphere Web Client. In the next video, we'll be looking at enabling vSAN and validating vSAN. Thanks for watching this video.